Allow me to introduce you to Zahana, a Malagasy nonprofit working in the high plateau of Madagascar, some 5 to 6 hours drive north of the capital of Antananarivo. We are guided by the philosophy of integrative participatory development, which I know is quite a mouthful. But the participatory part means you ask the community, what do you need the most, what are your priorities, and how can we together try to achieve your goals? The integrative part means that we are addressing all the issues at the same time. Be it access to clean water, a school, microcredit, reforestation, or improving cookstoves, all issues are addressed in tandem because they are interrelated. At our humble beginnings in 2005, the community's priority number one was access to clean, safe water. In true participatory fashion, they built their own water system themselves, working side by side with the water technicians who lived in the village for 2 months, digging trenches and laying pipes. The community-built water system has been flowing uninterrupted now for almost 15 years, which I may add is quite unique for development projects. We use the same approach for our schools. But the main focus of this presentation is reforestation. For over 10 years, Zahana has been employing by now 3 gardeners, one in each village, to grow seedlings for reforestation and introduce new crops. Most people in the West, when they hear Madagascar, think of lemurs and deforestation. But if you live there, trees disappear gradually because you need firewood to cook. But how do you convince rice farmers to become tree planters? As an incentive, we promised an award to the 3 most successful reforesters, knowing all too well that none of these poor rural farmers have ever received an award for anything. But our award had a twist. In the first, second, and third year, 3 people got an award for the largest number of trees planted that actually survived. The first year had the smallest, the second almost twice as much, but the biggest prize was in the third year, for the most trees planted that were still growing after 3 or more years. The award ceremony actually took place during the visit of the Minister of Health for the inauguration of our health center. Upscaling our reforestation, we moved the tree nursery from our gardener's backyard into the school grounds in 2019. More space allowed growing more seedlings to meet the higher demand. But it also allowed us to involve the students hands-on in the growing and taking care of tree seedlings. Watering the seedlings has become a fun game for the students every day and has become a part of their curriculum. In 2019, we teamed up with a group from a local college that developed an improved cookstove. Their cookstove can be built exclusively with locally made resources, where nothing needs to be bought from the outside. One of the participants summarized it beautifully and said, "Firewood that lasted for a week now lasts for 4 if you use an improved cookstove. Reducing the need for firewood protects trees more than anything else." But there is a twist. To qualify for a workshop on building an improved cookstove in your community, the community has to commit to reforestation. The seedlings provided by our gardeners need to be planted first to show to the team that the community is serious. Combining reforestation with improved cookstoves that actually work because you made it yourself is by far the most ambitious project to date. Currently, already 6 villages in the surrounding areas have been included, therefore expanding Zahana's reforestation efforts way beyond our initial villages. Thank you very much.
Talk to you soon.